John, when you look at the China-Hong Kong relationship, so a number of people think that China look at Hong Kong and maybe want it to get worse so then they can intervene. How would the international community take that if China were to intervene more aggressively in Hong Kong?
I think at the moment, the international community, in a very strange way, are slightly grateful to China for not intervening, because it puts everybody in a terrible position, quite apart from the moral side of it. I think if China does intervene in a heavy-handed way, then immediately some people's frustration with the protests now will then switch entirely towards sympathy with them, because in democratic countries you are allowed to protest. If they break the law, that's a different thing. But I do think at the moment that there is, you know, it's one of those things where there's a problem looking desperately for somebody to find a way out of this.
But what is a way out? I mean, it seems...
I think in the end that probably if there was something where maybe Lam went, where maybe other things moved a little bit and the protesters could claim something, but China could very obviously claim that it was still in control. But those two things, it's a bit like Brexit, they're becoming mutually incompatible. You know, a Chinese victory and a protest victory are beginning to look ever further apart.
John, how different is Hong Kong from 10 years ago, say the advent of the financial crisis? How different is it from the handover 20 years ago?
Well, it's a somewhat less free world, but it's still massively, massively more attractive to most Chinese as a place to make money and to save money and to keep money out of the state's reach than mainland China. It's obviously been bought into China a little bit more, but it's still, by most standards, it has the rule of law, it has all those different things, has freedom of the press. You know, we're allowed to follow all these things in a way that would be much harder inside the mainland. Those things make a difference. So Hong Kong is still recognizably different to the rest of China. Places like Singapore are trying to challenge it, whispering, at least quietly, that they offer a better and more secure home for money.
Well, this goes back 10 and 20 years, folks. The idea of Hong Kong was done, toast. It's the death of Hong Kong. I've heard at least 42 times. John, Shanghai was going to be the new Hong Kong. As you mentioned, Singapore was going to be the new Hong Kong. There's probably other cities you know I don't know. It's still Hong Kong, isn't it? I mean, Hong Kong is the capitalism of Asia, isn't it?
Yeah, again, there's a rather strange analogy, which I hadn't previously thought of, to London and Brexit. You know, yes, it is Hong Kong. Hong Kong's still the place where there is most financial action in that world. However, and it's becoming an ever bigger thing, you know, that the longer these things continue, the more that China begins to intervene, the more that dynamic changes. And I don't think it changes in a good way for Hong Kong. You've got two issues. You've got Shanghai, which they would like, the Chinese would like to be the financial capital. At the moment, it doesn't have the maturity and the depth of Hong Kong or the rule of law. But you've also got Singapore. You know, a lot of people will look harder at Singapore in the light of the past month's events and say, well, look, actually, maybe Singapore, for its occasional moments of autocracy, is a freer, better place to be.
Jeremy, will the trade war, you know, and the spat that's escalating almost daily with the U.S. actually keep Hong Kong in check? So, can China fight with Hong Kong whilst at the same time fighting with the U.S.?
Well, of course, that is a difficult balancing act. They clearly want to try and maintain as much macroeconomic stability as they can. They want to prevent and preclude significant capital outflows. And of course, if they were to amplify the political battles in Hong Kong, then that might amplify that. So they are in a rather difficult position. And I think that might be one factor which will limit or constrain their immediate reaction function.
It's quite interesting. I think Jeremy's right, a docile Hong Kong was slightly in the Chinese leadership's interest, somewhere where you could have a little bit of a pressure cooker, you could take some pressure off some things, and also a way for Chinese people who've made their money to begin to get some of that money offshore, which, albeit they don't want, but they know is bound to happen.